Hi, everybody. Good morning, good morning. Good morning to the United States. I don't know if I'm parked at a good spot. I think I am. There are some nice animals over here. So I'm just waiting for everyone to come in. Good evening, Philippines. Good morning, Alva. Good morning. Good evening, Sarah. Let me come closer so I can see. Good morning, Lolit, Pastor Lolit. Good morning, Sarah. How are you? I miss you, Sarah. God bless you. Thank you, Alva. And I'm running behind as I was trying to find a spot for parking. That's very important. Okay, hi, good morning, Gray. Good evening, Gray. Good evening, yes. While you're watching, you can go ahead and let us know where you're watching from. I know Canada is in the house. Good morning, Pabi. How are you? Philippines watching. Brother Ray is watching. Sarah from the Philippines is watching. Good morning and God bless you all. Well, good evening to all of you. I really thank you for coming in and joining me every Thursday. We're having like a mini gathering here, nationwide and worldwide, here on Road Download. So first of all, I want to just acknowledge the Holy Spirit once again. Holy Spirit, thank you. You are a special guest all the time. And, you know, we hang out with the Holy Spirit. We allow the Holy Spirit to minister to each one of us and to myself when I speak. Good evening, Nadi. There's my sister-in-law, Nadi. She's my brother's husband, Kuya Osmi, my elder brother. Hello, Kuya. Salamat. Maraming salamat sa mga prayers ninyo. And I really believe, you know, to all na nasa mga Pilipinas, magtatagalog muna ako. Hello, Anne Marmol. Thank you so much for joining. I really believe and that, you know, your prayers are avails much. And it's really making things happen. So I thank you so much to my family, my brother, and all my friends, and you know, for your prayers. Your prayers are supporting me to be up here and to continue to minister and to share the message of the Bible. And hi, Mom. Good morning. Good evening there. Thank you so much for joining me. It's really exciting to see everyone coming together worldwide. So those who are going to watch this on a replay, I just want to let you know you're in my prayers. We love you and we're with you wherever you are. You know, if you do need, just, you know, send me your name and just tell me, you know, to pray for you, anything like that, because I know that even just with the name and praying you up, that we all come together and our Heavenly Father already have given us everything. Our Heavenly Father has already provided everything to us. And so hi, Lolit, Pastor Lolit, thank you for joining. Hello, Pastor Ariel and Pastor Pressy. Shortly, I will be on Kingdom Talk. But let me, there's just a couple of things in my mind, in my spirit right now. You know, there are, but I'm going to go ahead and share what, you know, I have in my spirit this morning about being a yeast. You know, that he, in Matthew 13, verse 33, because I want to share and I want to encourage everyone about confidence. Hi, Susan. Good morning. Good evening. Hi, Teresa. Good morning, Teresa, or good afternoon, or good morning, wherever you are. Just greetings to all of you. Thank you. So, hi, good morning, Franco. The empowerment man is in the house. Good morning, Franco. Welcome. Pastor Ariel. Hi, Pressy. Hello. How are you? So, I just want to share a little bit about the confidence that we have as sons of God. You know, I do a lot of meditations, and really, we have to be much more awakened There is a greater awakening. Now that we know and understand about the gospel of the kingdom of God, and we know Jesus Christ, you probably have read the Bible many times, but it seems like, and I feel like, and in my spirit, that there is much greater awakening. There is that greater awakening of the sons of God, that these things that was written in the Bible and that God or Jesus has spoken to us, being the messengers, being like a yeast, being like a, being like a mustard seed, being like the man who found a treasure. All those things that he has mentioned in the Bible of what the kingdom of God is going to fully manifest. But I know for sure there's still a greater awakening that is in the horizon. And we have to be ready for that greater awakening, because that greater awakening is not coming out from this world. That is coming out from you, from me, from the sons of God. There is a greater awakening in our own body, in our own lives, that truly the kingdom of God is come. So in Matthew 13, verse 33, the Bible said there that the kingdom of God is like a leaven, is like a yeast that a woman took. Hi, Helen, good morning. That a woman took and hid. Look at that word. The woman took the yeast and hid it. Hid it where? She hid it with the 3 measures of meals or flour. So there is a process that when we receive, when we have the revelation, when we have the understanding of the gospel of the kingdom of God. Now remember, the kingdom of God is where? Is in us. So when we receive the message of the gospel of the kingdom of God, the good news that, hey, the kingdom of God is here. A woman took it and hid it in 3 full measures of meals. Now, the meals are not prepared yet. You know, she mixed it with the dough. She mixed it with the meal, because there is a time that after the mixing of it, there will be a process that will go through the mixing of the yeast and the dough until it becomes fully expressed as a bread. You know, I'm just making an example, like a bread. Or whatever meal you have. You know, if you want to add yeast on your meal to make it fluffy, you know, that's what we think about. To make it fluffy, to make it rice, let's get the yeast. So us as the kingdom citizens, as the sons of God, the kingdom of God is in us. We are that yeast for this world. We become the fermenting agent. We become the one that makes this world fluffy and elevate. So Let me go back there on the personal, being a yeast. Let's start with personal first, then we're going to go to the corporate one. Our personal growth is so important. Our personal living is so important before we can become really effective in the corporate kingdom of God, in the corporate body, and the corporate gathering of the sons of God, and also to impact the world. So when the woman took, hi, Papa B, rise up. Yes, we're going to rise up. And let me tell you, when the kingdom of God is in us, there is a time the word hid. The word hid means it is hidden in us. The kingdom of God is in you now. You are already in the process. You, no matter how you want it or not, because the kingdom of God is alive, it is already causing a change in the inside of you. You may not see it yet, but it's already causing you a change with the inside of you to become the yeast, to become that yeast. So your body, your spirit is changing to be that of a yeast, because initially, without the being born again, without the understanding and the knowledge of the kingdom of God, we're just a dough. We're just a flour. We're just a flat dough. But when the spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, which is the kingdom of God, comes in us, then we become a dough with a yeast. And now the dough has been mixed to become alive, not alive, to become to move up, to get activated in order for that dough to rise and become that fullness of the kingdom of God and as sons of God. So when you receive the gospel of the kingdom of God, it's hidden first. And that is very personal. You know, you will have your own personal growth, your own personal intimacy. First thing is your intimacy with the Father and the Holy Spirit in you. He is working in the inside of us because His purpose is that we rise up first as an individual and as a son, so that when we rise up, then we can become what comes out of a yeast. What comes out of a yeast? So when the yeast works in us and completely makes us and like a yeast, instead now, you know, we say now the yeast bread. We call a yeast bread because now we know the bread is yeasted. So you can't separate the yeast from the bread. So now you become the yeast. As a yeast now, you are given that catalyst, that enzyme, that powerful agent. That's in the inside of you, which is the kingdom of God and the Holy Spirit, that when you go mix with the world, now I'm talking about mixing with the world. When you say mixing with the world, you go into the world. You know, you build relationships. You build a friendship. You build a relationship people at work. Now, you have to have the confidence that when you are there, something is going to happen in that place or in that person who you are with, because it is inevitable, because your nature now as a yeast, your nature now as a yeast of the kingdom of God will work itself for others, not you acting on it. You know, you just staying there and your power is being manifested. And let me tell you this, you will not elevate. You know, personally, you're elevated by God, but we want to elevate the world. But we can't elevate the world to what God wants it to be unless we come together with them and elevate them. Because we are the yeast that's causing them to elevate and rise up to the level of godliness, to the level of the kingdom lifestyle. Now, with that mixing, and let me tell you this, when we mix, when we go out where the dough is and elevate that dough, you and I will elevate as well. So it is a mutual thing. If you're looking for elevation, if you're looking for an increase in our lives, go find and mix with the dough. Go find the flour. I mean, the flour. Go out there, because your growth, your potential, your power will be seen to those who are in the lowly places. Those who are in the lowly places is where God is placing you, because you're already a yeast. You're already a yeast that is risen up for God's glory. Now, we as children of God, our mandate, we have work to do. We're not only being transformed and elevated in the inside, but God is doing that to us so that we can elevate others. That is our assignment and work, that we go out there so we can elevate others, bring them to the level of the kingdom of God in the spirit. And once we elevate them, the higher we get elevated to, because we're mixing with them. When they rise up, who rises up? We rise up too. So, you know, we are rising up, can be found in helping others, in loving others, in lifting up others. Our power that God has given us is that. You know, what I'm thinking is, you may not even do a whole lot of work. You really don't, because as a yeast, the yeast just mixes there, and once it gets activated, you know, the flour just draws the power from the yeast. So that's who you are. when you're mixed with the dough, when you're in the world is gonna draw power from you for them to get elevated and for them to come out of the darkness, for them to come out of the lowly places where God did not intend for this world to be. God intends for this world to be rising up to the level of the spiritual heavenly realm. And we as children of God are those that are going to influence the world to bring it up to a higher level. That's why we got to have the confidence. We got to have the confidence. The confidence that we're the ones who's bringing the kingdom of God in this world that will elevate it. And at the same time, we will be much elevated, you know, when we continue to do that. Our success, I'm going to say this one more time. Hi, Isaiah, good morning. Our success, I want to ask you, what is success to you? What is your success? You know, success in this world is not the success in the kingdom of God, the way we see it. The success that this world has, or the idea of success in this world, is not the true success that God has laid in each one of us. God wants us to be elevated. God wants us to be successful as sons of God. And that is that we fulfill our assignment in bringing up this world into a level that is of the heavenlies, that is of the above. So do we get that through our professions? Yes, we do. We impact the others by the Spirit and the kingdom of God that is in us. My success, and I'm going to share this with you. I know you have your own success that you want in life. What is it that you truly desire that is success to you? That is the success that is not of this world. Do you want a big house? Do you want a nice car? Yes, I can have that. I want that. Who will say no to that? But those are secondary or maybe tertiary things. Those are accessory things. Those things will follow me. You know, those things will follow me. And whatever God has given to me, I am content. We got to be content as well in the inside of us. Whether we see if we have a big house or not, whether we see we have a car, whether we see our bank account is full, whether we see we have nice clothes and we have plenty of chauffeurs, we have to be content, you know, of who we are, and be confident, be content and be confident. And those who are blessed, God bless you, you know, that you are being blessed, that you are in that realm, because in that realm, you could do so much. You could do so much to elevate those who are poor in the spirit, who are poor in their hearts, who are poor in the physical being, who are sick in the body, who are mourning. Because you have been given more for that the kingdom of God can be expanded through you. Because you have been blessed with me in situation that I have right now. That my success, I love so much that whatever God wants me to be and where to be, that I will be used in that situation. Whether I go anywhere, whatever He puts me there, I want to make sure that the kingdom of God in the inside of me will be poured out in that place. And here's the thing. Here is the things. Let me tell you, you have got to be confident. You have got to reach that faith level and confidence that you are a yeast. That a yeast can, you know, makes, is an activating factor. It is an activating material. That you are the yeast, that you are infecting the world. You have to have a confidence that you know when you are with someone or somewhere that something is already happening in there. Glory to God. I really, hi Luz Buminda. This is so powerful. And dear, this is really so powerful to me because my heart and my spirit God is laying this on me, and I know this, and I'm believing this, and I'm just proclaiming this into me and unto my life, because I want to bless my life too by the words of God. I can speak to myself and my body and bless me, that God, that wherever I am, that a piece of you, that a nature of you is coming out of me and pouring and attaching to the people around me, that whatever is attaching to them will be that of your contact agent. You know, God just needs a contact for the spirit to contact a person. It doesn't need a touch from you. It only needs maybe a, you know how your skin dries up, your skin takes a how do you say that? Your skin rebuilds every moment. Every moment. You know, just to get the dust of your skin. Our skin, the dust is made of skin. So when you go to somebody's house, your skin is shedding. Your skin is shedding in that house. So when you go in someone else's house, pray for your skin and say, God, whatever skin is shedding in my body right now, let it be a blessing in this room. Let it be a blessing in this house. Let it be a blessing in this church. And I speak, for my dead cell skins will bring life, that whoever touches my skins that's shedding off will be touched by your glory, will be touched by your light, that they will sense your presence in the spirit. That is how powerful we are. Just imagine, when Jesus sent the word by his mouth, he was not even present. Jesus doesn't have to be present in the physical to manifest the power. But you remember that Jesus sent his word, and even the centurion, he just sent his word. He was not even present. Just your voice and the sound of your voice will cause healing in someone right now. Even in the voice, my voice right now, Holy Spirit, that you anoint whatever is released through my voice, that it will cause healing in a body of a person who has an illness right now, that the fever will go, that just through the sound and the frequency of my voice, that things will be healed and mend up. Those who are brokenhearted will receive joy right now. Those who are depressed will receive understanding right now. Those who are in poverty will receive some prosperity right now. Those who are reaching out for help are going to be met right now because of the word, Father God. And I believe so much with the tone and the tune and pitch of my voice, that I am commanding all these things that are not of God, I'm commanding in the name of Jesus to be gone to the person who is listening right now. For you have no authority on that person, for God created that person for his glory. And now I rebuke the enemy, I rebuke the attacks of the enemy to be gone and go and be removed. Whoever you are, be gone, and I set you free in the name of Jesus Christ. You are free indeed, just because the power of the voice of the Holy Spirit, that it is released right now through the instrument of my voice, that it will release power in you, that whatever you are looking for is found, that whatever you're seeking for, you will find, that whatever you knock on the door will be open to you. For that is what God has said in the Bible, that whatever you ask, you will receive, that whenever you seek, you will find, and when you knock on the door, it will be open for you. So right now, go ahead and ask and receive it, because it's already been done. It's already been done. My voice is coming short a little bit. It's already been done. So receive it. Receive it. And I command the spirit of doubt, I command the spirit of doubt to be gone right now in the name of Jesus. I speak to the spirit of fear, be gone. You have no power and authority to this person right now in the name of Jesus. Go and flee and come no more. But I lose the spirit of love. I lose the spirit of healing upon your life right now, that it is sealed by the blood of the Lamb. And continue and go on and walk and move on, healed, powerful, uplifted, and being upheld by the glory of God in you. Because Jesus came to heal the sick. Jesus came to give abundant life. We already have that. We have to receive it and walk in it. For you have been And you have been resurrected. You're now in a resurrected life. A resurrected life doesn't have sickness. A resurrected life doesn't have headaches. A resurrected life doesn't have painful knees. A resurrected life doesn't have diabetes in the name of Jesus. A resurrected life is wholeness. A resurrected life has no stroke in the name of Jesus. I cancel all these attacks of the enemies, because these are superficial things that the enemy is doing unto us. Because we have resurrected, we carry the body of Jesus in a resurrected state. So arise and go, people of God. Arise, sons of God. Make yourself walk knowing in confidence that we have the resurrected life of God inside of us. Thank you so much. I'm running out of my voice. I feel like I'm losing here. But powerful, powerful. Glory to God. You know, I want to just tell you before I go, because I have to be gone in 8:30. I want to let you know, I am believing with you. I am believing with you. I am believing with you that you are healed, you're whole in the name of Jesus Christ. So don't come to me. And I don't want to come to myself with complaints, with saying things that is not of a resurrected life. Let us refuse the things that the enemy is telling in our minds and making us feel in our body. Refuse it, because we have the power of choice. That now we have the power of choice, not just the power of choice, but we're choosing the great message, the truth that Jesus has spoken. And whatever truth says, that's where we're going to stand on and live by. That the truth is we are free. That the truth is we can walk free. Thank you, God. Thank you for your truth, Jesus Christ, that we are enlightened by you. Thank you so much. I want to cut this short. I will see you next time. If you do want to watch this in continuation, just in a minute, I will be with Pastor Ariel on Kingdom Talk. I love you all. God bless you. I will answer all your calls and I will be praying for you. Hi, Yen from Saudi Arabia. Hello, everybody. Hal Rao from Singapore. Thank you so much for those who are watching. And just let you know, I love you and I will see you next time. Get going with your resurrected life. And your resurrected life is your confidence. Be confident. I love you all. God bless you.